What's in a broadside ballad? History, poetry, law, music, imagery, business. Broadside Ballads Online represents the work of three major online archives that combine their expertise to make information about ballads more detailed, more accessible, and ready for innovative methods of searching. A new model for describing ballads allows libraries and archives to connect four centuries of cultural heritage with the history of popular literature and the living tradition of folk song. A new method of searching images and printed ballads is pioneered by Broadside Ballads Online.
I think the current project is valuable on two fronts. Yes, it is going to make things much more findable, and it's also going to encourage other collections out there which aren't yet adequately described to adopt a good standard of description. I think one of the great positives of this is that we are finally nailing the difficult question of how to describe ballads. Of course, ballad sheets are incredibly complex objects when you think it's just a single sheet of paper, but what there is on it and what it can tell us is so rich, and providing people with the tools to do the job which will enable them to describe them well is, I think, a great service to the community.
Why put politics in a ballad? That's a funny place to put it. And the reason for that, you might say, is because, you know, it's easy for people to remember the words because they're rhyming, or this is the cheapest form of literature. But from my research, it seems to me the reason why those politics are in a song is because politics is about creating harmony in the state, and that the songs that are talking about politics are often using the language of harmony in order to talk about the ideal state, how we want the state to be, why there is discord in the state. And the ballad, therefore, if you like, the medium is the message. The ballad is the perfect vehicle to try and talk about harmony of the state.
Thank you, Angela. How about the potential for an integrated search of broadside ballads from you, from the period that you studied, the 17th century? What's that going to do for your research?
I think that this is just the most fantastic development. As somebody who's had to be flitting across the Atlantic to go and look at other people's ballads, this just gives the opportunity that just wasn't available when I began working on these things in 1998. The ballad world has changed entirely.
Just through the information being potentially all in one place, and potentially being able to combine it and structure it in various ways to make connections between parts of ballads, whether they are ballad tunes, ballad texts, ballad illustrations, the printing of histories of ballads. Ballads are complicated multimedia objects. By being able to relate them, elements of them, to elements of other ballads, we're going to create a kind of much richer record of balladry, I think, and not just in broadside ballads, but ballads as literary works, as musical works, as objects that have performance histories. That richness is going to create something that's much larger than our existing kind of understanding of ballads, and much more detailed.